And welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm the RPG chick. I want to apologize to you guys. I completely forgot for like a couple days to even put up last Monday's episode. I majorly screwed up. I couldn't believe it. I remembered on Wednesday and I was like, well, what am I going to do? Then record an episode on Wednesday, have it go up on Thursday, but then they only have Friday, Saturday, and Sunday to cast a vote. So the next one's on Sunday. I'm like, I'm just going to have to wait. So I really do apologize. No one said anything, so for all I know, no one noticed. But I do want to be honest and all that. So it was unanimous last time. Everyone said that we should get in the boat and not jump into the Tabaji moat. Yeah, I can't take credit for that. See last video for whoever wrote that. It was very clever. You hurry over to the boat and try to hide at one end, turned away from the other sailors so none will see your face, but your caution seems unnecessary. The men are unconcerned by the fact... The men are unconcerned by the fact they do not know you. Okay. The boat is lowered into the river and quickly sculled to the far bank. You can't help cheering at your escape until you remember the other prisoners still trapped in the hold, you know, with the werewolf. And we've changed from baboon to monkey at some point. I just noticed that. Maybe that's because we cowardly ran away instead of facing it, but I really can't fight a werewolf to 2 stamina. And 0 rations and 3 gold. We're in bad. We need like a major, like, I don't know, a good luck happening to occur. I don't know if this is normal or if I'm just majorly screwing up this game, why we're so bad off like this. So we're still need to get to the other side, which is how that all started. You slip out of the boat and hurry away up the path while the other men tie the painter. I guess that's a part of a boat and not somebody who paints who's being tied up. Free and in the right place to continue your journey. Oh, it said the men seem not concerned. They do not know you or something. I guess you just let me on the boat. You slip out of the boat. Like I'm, like, hidden, though. It's written. I don't get this part. Alright, on the far side. On the far bank. You have reached the banks of Upper Kharé. The buildings here are not as grand as on the south side of the river, but they're in much better condition. Fewer people live on this side, away from the fields and the hills, but those that do are richer. They are also most likely more dangerous. But of course, it is on this side of the city that the North Gate stands, which we're really just trying to pass through this city, right? But this entire chapter starts here. It all takes place in the city, from what I understand. Start moving. You follow the road away from the river towards a fork in the road. If there are any nobles still in the city port, their houses are most likely to be on this side of the river, but which way? Yeah, I don't know. I want to get, like, a bunch of money from one of them. Alright, we can't choose a path yet, but we will come to the fork and then do so. The early morning sun is beginning to wake the streets of Kharé. A few creatures roam this way and that. In one corner, a spring bubbles with fresh water. Will this improve our stamina? I'm going to drink from the fountain. I'm afraid if I look around or ask someone for directions that this choice will be gone, so let's drink from the fountain. Yes! Nice! 5! We're up to 7 stamina. 70. You cup your hand to the water and drink a mouthful. It is fresh and invigorating, as though the water was enchanted. It must be if we get 5 stamina. Yeah, we had 2. 5 stamina from just drinking water. Let's look around. Looking left, the road heads through a residential area that seems well cared for. A short way off to the right is an open plaza. Let's ask someone for directions. You stop a passing creature. Excuse me, I need to ask you. The creature's head is bowed, and it doesn't look up, but it pulls itself free and hurries away. It is too miserable to speak. There is nothing for it. You will have to explore for yourself. Okay. Well, this way we head to this Fireview Square. And possibly after the Halls of Vlada. Ooh, the necropolis is over there. I do want to check that out, although it's brimming with danger. Hope to be at much better stamina by the time we reach this necropolis. Fallen Quarter, Gardens of Briar. This way goes to the Red Quarter. You know, I want to go this way. Because I'm thinking, of course, the way this game is played out so far, it hasn't worked that way. But what I'm thinking is if I go this way, I could possibly check out all these things. And that if I go this way, I'll hit the Red Quarter and the North... Ooh. Although it doesn't look like we can get to the North Gate that way. There's a path. Oh. Are you serious? What kind of city is this? In order to get out the North Gate, you have to pass through this necropolis. Are people really comfortable with doing that? That's the only way up. To go here, to whatever this is, and then the North, or the North Gate. There's all this, but it's blocked off. Figured someone would build a ramp or a bridge. I guess they have a reason for doing that, which we may find out. I'm not sure. All right, so let's go this way, because we're going to end up hitting at least someone. No, I want to check out... Yeah. Sorry, guys. I'm so indecisive. Let me turn right and see if we can check out this Fireview Square. I'm kind of interested with that in particular for some reason. You turn right, heading away from the city wall. A sign points towards Fireview Square. You pass large houses that have the aspect of official places of business. One is marked with the clawed fist of a moneylender. An elven woman is just leaving. She looks quite worn out already, this early in the morning. Let's try to talk to her. You stop the woman with a gesture. She looks up at you in some surprise. Worn out. Or distraught. It's just two different things. Yeah, let's just see. Let's be nice. Trying to be nice. If we like be nice and stuff, good things will come our way, like rations and gold and stuff. You seem distraught. She looks at you, her narrow eyes wide. Oh, stranger, she moans. You have no idea. I will help you, you declare. She pulls a face. You? Why would you do that? I cannot pay you, as I'm sure you can guess. I'm an adventurer. She takes a step back. I've had enough adventures from one lifetime, thank you. Always the same with adventurers. Every day, a new adventure. I have to be going. Wait. She steps away, then stops, looking at you expectantly. She wipes a tear from her eye. Maybe you'll need a guide? That would be useful. We can't pay you. I don't want to pay her. I need to find a scholar. I need to find an undead creature. A blind beggar. A scholar. Sure, a scholar. The North Gate will come in time. Actually, I know where it is. I need to find a scholar called Lorag, you reply. She nods. I do not know him, but I know where he lives. I can take you there. She nods, clearly pleased. And how much do you charge? She sizes you up for a moment. 4 gold pieces. I can't. You shake your head. No, I will find my own way. Very well. May you stand in the first portal trap you see. Wrapping her cloak tightly around herself, she steps to one side and hurries off down the street. You watch her go with some sympathy. You've found one new clue. That's what we get for not giving away her... Which would be, actually... Unless we got gold, we wouldn't be able to pay her the other half later. You've found one new clue. Alright. A clue! A clue! So... Portal traps. Kharé is protected by a series of portal traps. Well, she could be just making all that up for all we know. Onward! The alley gets wider, and passing a long building on the left which seems to be full of children. On the step, a lanky man sits with his eyes firmly closed. Look at him. You pause to look him over. He's tall, well-dressed, but not healthy-looking. He seems pale and thin. Greet him. You go over to the man to greet him. He does not look up at you. What is this building? You ask. The man does not look at you. His eyes remain closed. Is he asleep? I am a stranger in this city. I don't want to place window stones with him. He ignores you, clearly uninterested in who or what you are. This is clearly a waste of your time. The man is an idiot, or worse. I don't have the goal to be playing swindle stones. I'm just going to have to leave him then. You step away from the creature and continue along the road. It's funny how they all turn out to be creatures. In the end, whether we're human or orc or demon, we're all creatures. Okay, onto the square. Cool. This is where I wanted to go, at least. You follow the road between large houses until it enters a wide square. Odd-looking creatures mill about, going about their business. Several are clustered in a crowd around a monument of some kind. On the other side of the square, the main road continues on through a low arch. A thousand other alleyways lead off in all directions into Upper Kharé. A thousand alleyways. Well... Look at the creatures. It's very interesting. I don't know if that's a hat or a horn or something else. Creatures push and knock into you as they make their way across the plaza. Despite there being plenty of space, none of them seem to be looking where they are going. There's something strange about them in general. Their bodies are spindly, their faces long with downturned mouths. In fact, their eyes all seem to be closed. Okay. They're blind spider creatures. I forget what the name of those things. Dryders, right. Yeah, from D&D. Although dryders actually have... 8 legs, I believe. They're a little more spidery-like. But when you say their bodies are spindly, faces long with downturned mouths, they're bugs. They're bug people. Or spider people. Wave in front of a creature's... Why would I do this? Okay, I feel compelled to do so, though. Curious, you wave your hand in front of one creature's response. Face, sorry. There's no response. A peddler with a tray around his neck walks past you in the square. Anklewort, Blimberry, Poultice of Millweed. Pick a creature's pocket. I am so tempted right now. Let's talk to the herbalist. You cross the square. Okay, I got a cross to go here. You stop the herbalist. Good day, he greets you. Can I interest you in a poultice? A salve? I need advice. You reply. Alright, that's a mistake there. Not a poultice. The herbalist shrugs weakly. I only have poultices. Salves and ointments. I'm looking for a scholar. The herbalist smiles. There's an old man called Lorag who lives near here. He replies, in the large house near the prison. If you're going that way, can I recommend something? He digs around on his tray. A mustic ointment, made from pure mustic. What does it do? Mustic is a powerful hypnotic, he replies. It can make you believe almost anything. He holds it out for you to smell. Oh my god. Proofreader? No. Don't smell it, because if it's going to make me believe almost anything, he's going to make me believe I need to surrender all three of my remaining gold to, yeah, don't. You lean away, careful not to inhale from the south. He smiles and takes a deep breath himself, sighing happily. What is he making himself believe? Give it to me? Give me something else. How much does it cost? You ask, suspicious. A pot of this size? He holds up a container no larger than your thumb. 4 gold pieces. It's very valuable. He smiles and takes a deep breath himself, sighing happily. Another one. Give me something else. I'm not going to buy anything. I'm just curious what he has. You tell him, you owe me. He believes it. Oh my god. I'm gonna go to hell. Give me your most expensive item. And then you know what I might do? I might try to sell it back to him. I don't think I can, but... you know, this, we don't have really freedom to do stuff like that. If the option comes up, I'd be very tempted, though. We need money. We seriously need money. Give him something else. You tell him you owe me. I was like, why am I saying that? Does he really owe me? The man nods, his pupils dilated wide. Of course I do, he agrees. I know I do. What do you want? What else do you have? A blimberry salve, the man replies. Made from finest blimberries. What does that do? You ask. The herbalist shrugs. It's good for headaches, I believe. Smells awful. The man smiles. Show me something else. The herbalist nods and goes through his stock, picking out another bottle. How about this? Essence of bark. Good for sore throats. Essence of bark. If I say I don't want it, I might be... sorry, I sound loud to myself. If I say I don't want it, that might be it. So, I'm going to hell. We're going to change from monkey to, like, you know, buzzard or something. Give it to me. The herbalist gives you the bark essence bottle. You bid the man farewell, and he walks away across the square. A man pushes a wheeled cart of fruit and sets up a stall. Well, okay. I'm bad. I normally don't do stuff like this, guys, but we are in dire straits. I need food, too. Any of the rest of my gold really has to go towards buying rations. As cheap rations as possible. Also, I'm tempted to pick someone's pocket. I mean, in a city like this, it's kind of normal to do, right? Picking pockets. My pocket was picked. Why not pick someone else's pocket? Getting so bad now. I just need stuff, you know? Visit the fruit vendor. Your stomach rumbles at the sight of fresh fruit. Fruit seller! You walk over to the fruit seller. Morning, he declares, morosely. His eyes, like everyone else's, are closed. I'd say it was a beautiful day, but it isn't. Would you like to buy something? He waves a hand across an eclectic tray of fruit, all of it rotten, except for one glistening mamba fruit. Now, if I had smelled that thing, I might be convinced that all this food is fresh and delicious. Glistening bamba fruit. Let's talk to him now. So, you begin. Can you tell me a little about this part of Kharé? The fruit vendor shrugs. Of course I can. This is where no one buys any fruit. That's why it all goes rotten. And he goes quiet, not wanting to talk anymore. Look at the bamba. How much for the bamba, you ask? 4 gold pieces, the vendor replies. They're good for you, you know. You check your purse, but you don't have enough. I'm well aware of that. Pick through the fruit. You pick through the fruit, eventually finding an apple, which is not too disgusting. 2 gold pieces, the fruit vendor says. You'll say it's too much, of course, and you'd be right, but I can't charge you less. So tempted. We're gonna be good, though. I mean, I did technically just steal something from that guy. I I, you know, what's the word? I deceived him. So, or I let him be deceived, yeah. I mean, I knew he wasn't of sound mind, and I lied and took his thing. 2 gold pieces. I'm going to buy it. It's either going to increase stamina or rations. So either way, we need both. 1 gold, 1 ration. You buy it as much out of pity as anything else. You are hungry. It looks appealing. Stash it. You put the apple in your pack. You talk to him some more. Your purchase has opened him up a bit. I'm new to this part of the city, you say. Any directions? The fruit vendor nods, eyes still closed. What are you looking to find? Not meaning, I hope. I can't believe we have 1 gold. I need to find a man called Lorak. The fruit vendor nods. I've heard of him, but I don't know him. He lives somewhere around here. He pauses to rearrange his fruit, accidentally sticking his thumb through a moldy plum as he does so. Blech. Disgusting. Why even have that, you know, why have moldy stuff? Just throw it out. I need to find his spell lines, yeah. For the North Gate, you tell him. The vendor laughs. Ah, so that's what you're about. Well, you're gonna get your head cut off, going around saying that to people. I need to find a blind beggar. Then. Lots of beggars around here, he answers. They don't buy anything. I need a particular one. There's lots to choose from. Through there, the ruins of the Free Trade Quarter. He points to an alleyway leading off the main square. I need to find an undead creature. Try the city graveyard, he replies. No one goes there. It's definitely haunted. Follow the main road past the statue and through the market. I guess no one goes back and forth from the north gate then, because you have to go there just to get there and back. Or back. Where do you get your fruit? From another fruit seller, he answers sadly. That's why it's all rotten. You have nothing else to say. You bid farewell to the fruit seller and head away from the stall into the center of the square. Got another clue! The beggar is in the ruins. Can be found in the ruins of the fallen quarter. Loud music. Okay, back to the square. It's just all we can choose. What's next? Halls of Vlada? We need to, like, find some gold pieces. I will work for money. If we can rest down somewhere for the night, which doesn't cost money, I will eat and sleep. Return to the middle of the square. The creatures in the square mill about, talking in hushed tones to each other. Look through the arch. It sounds tempted every time I see it. Look through the arch. The arch at the far end of the square is thronged with more creatures. Not all the same as those in the square. There seems to be a bustling hub beyond. A market district, perhaps? From around the monument, you hear a sudden gasp. Something has happened? Approach the monument. You approach the crowd around the monument, which is so thick it's hard to see inside. Here, says one of the creatures, whom you nudge accidentally. Be careful. Apologize? You apologize, and the creature huffs and moves away through the crowd. Okay, he did steal my 1 gold. Clambering up the steps of the monument, you finally get to see inside, but the monument seems to be empty. There is just a circular rug that fills the floor space. The crowd murmurs and whispers. I'm going to throw a coin inside. I only have 1 coin. Let's ask someone about it. What is this monument? You ask one of the creatures. Can't you tell? The creature replies. Were you born yesterday? No, I was born the day before. I'm a stranger here. We don't like strangers, the creature replies. The crowd is hustled around the monument as though expecting the rug inside to move. Do I dare? I'm not throwing a coin. I only have one. So I'm either moving away or stepping into. God damn. You know what? It's going to be a little bit shorter episode. We are 25 minutes in. That's not that bad. What do you think, guys? This is out. I'm looking for a step into the monument or a step away. So, yeah. Leave your comment below. Let me know which I should do. You know, I'm looking for money. I'm looking for stamina. I'm looking for rations. It's basically what it is. Or the opportunity to get some. So, I don't know. Maybe I should step away. Or maybe stepping into the monument will lead us on an adventure which I can find much riches. I don't know. I mean, we could possibly survive a fight. We do have 7 stamina, not as bad. If we had 2, I'd definitely be stepping away. So let me know what you guys think. Step into the monument or step away. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next one, and I will not forget. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.